Thank you very much. Allentown. I know it well. 8 days, you believe that? 8 days from now, we're going to win the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and we are going to win 4 more great years in the White House. I want to begin today by discussing an issue of existential importance to Pennsylvania, very, very important. Last week, Sleepy Joe Biden made perhaps the most shocking admission ever uttered in the history of presidential debates. In other words, he blew it. On live television, 91-9. Did you see that? 91. Did you know what that means? 91-9. But we won't talk about that for the fake news. Joe Biden confirmed his plan to abolish the entire U.S. oil industry. That means no fracking, no jobs, no energy for Pennsylvania families, Texas, all the other places. He wants to go wind. Let's go wind. Let's go have brownouts, blackouts all over Pennsylvania, all over the country. He wants to go wind. He wants to go with windmills that are made in Germany and China and send big, big carbon into the air when they're making them. You know that, right? From a different continent, but that's okay. Biden's plan is an economic death sentence for Pennsylvania's energy sector. I think you all know that. Did you see it, though? Do you believe it? And even the anchor, who I thought did a very good job, by the way, Kristen, I thought she did a very good job. She said, why do you say that? Remember that? Why are you saying that? Why do you say that? He will eradicate your energy and send Pennsylvania into a crippling depression. Somehow that doesn't sound good, Mr. Congressman, does it? Huh? The Biden energy shutdown, and he wants to shut down the whole country. And we're rounding the turn. You know, all they want to talk about is COVID. By the way, on November 4th, you won't be hearing so much about it. COVID, COVID, COVID. COVID. Today, let's talk about COVID all over Europe, right? Europe, Mike, they don't talk about that. Now we're rounding the turn, and we have the vaccines coming out very soon, years ahead of schedule. If he would have done it like he did the H1N1 swine flu, one of the worst handled, that was an epidemic. It was a disaster. He had no idea what the hell he was doing, but you know that. The Biden energy shutdown would inflict deep pain and misery on Pennsylvania, mass layoffs, constant blackouts and brownouts, soaring gas prices. Nice to have that $2 gasoline, isn't it? Surging energy bills, no air conditioning in the summer, no heat during the winter, and no electricity during peak hours. Let's watch President Trump on television. I'm sorry, we won't be able to do it. The wind isn't blowing today, darling. We won't be able. No, it doesn't power those big factories that we're opening up all over the country. Biden's running mate, Kamala Harris. Oh. Did you see her last night on television with the laugh? Ha, ha, ha. She was laughing at a horrible question about her, and she just laughed. She found it so funny. Most liberal senator. She's the most liberal senator by far. She's more liberal than Crazy Bernie. Even sponsored the $100 trillion Green New Deal. The Green New Deal. No, I don't think so. The Green New Deal would be an economic disaster for our nation, certainly for this state. Biden and Harris have a pledge to join and rejoin the Paris. Look, you know about Paris? The Paris Climate Accord, one of the great disasters of all time. Just call up France. How's Paris doing? Shipping your energy jobs to foreign polluters all over China, all over the rest of the world. And you know, it was hard bringing them back. We brought our jobs back. A lot of our jobs are coming back now. They're coming back now. You know, and speaking about jobs, I want to thank the people that own this plant. You know, you have a governor named Tom Wolf, I guess. Tom Wolf. This thing was set up just a few hours ago. That's why it's so incredible that people across the street trying to get it. This was set up because your governor made it almost impossible for us to find any site. Normally, we would have had an airport. we would have gotten in. We would have had a — I mean, this is really a nice place. No, I want to thank the trucking company. They're great. They're supporters. But we just found it a little while ago because they were shut out. We had a deal. It was a deal, and they broke the deal, headed by Governor Tom Wolf, who's got your whole — who's got your whole Commonwealth shut down. Whole Commonwealth is shut down. Although probably on November 4th it'll open. They'll announce on November 4th. Did you see the one governor said, no, I think we should be open by around November 4th. Oh, thank you, man. No, they think they're going to inflict harm and bad numbers. Our numbers are so good. Our comeback numbers are the best anywhere in the world. Doesn't matter. But you know what? It does inflict tremendous harm on the people that are shut out of their jobs, that are going to lose their jobs with suicides and drugs and alcohol and all the problems. So, Tom Wolf, next time, give us a little notice, Governor. And I'll remember it, Tom. I'm going to remember it, Tom. Hello, Mr. President. This is Governor Wolf. I need help. I need help. You know what? These people are bad. We go out of our way, regardless, Republican, Democrat, when they have a problem. But he shut us out, and he tried shutting us out of two other venues. You know, we have three of these today in Pennsylvania. Three of these. And these just came out. I have to say, because I watch in the fake news, there has never been anything like what's happening now. But these just came out. So Rasmussen just came out. Trump is leading. You know, that's been one of the most accurate polls. You don't read it. In fact, a pollster called us yesterday, said, you have really good numbers, but they won't accept them when we put them out. They don't put them out. Unless they're negative, the press doesn't put them out. Can you know? This is serious. And how about big tech? How about the Biden scandal? And they're not even covering it. They don't want to talk about it. And by the way, that's a real scandal. And the press doesn't want to write about it, except for the New York Post. The press won't write about it. And big tech won't take it. People have no idea what's going to happen in Pennsylvania. That I can tell you. I know Pennsylvania. Don't forget, I went to school in Pennsylvania. I went to school in Pennsylvania, college, and I know it much better than he does. You know, he's always talking about, I grew up, right? I grew up in Pennsylvania. He grew up nowhere. He didn't grow up. No, did you watch him on 60 Minutes last night? Did you see yesterday when he called me George? No, I don't know if I like George. No, no. Not George. What a mess. What a mess. No, he called me George. I don't know if I should be insulted or happy about it. I'm sort of insulted. That's the first time that's happened to me in a long time.
President Trump there addressing the crowd of supporters in Allentown in Pennsylvania. Sky's Sally Lockwood is watching in New York for us. Hello to you, Sally. The first of three rallies in the state of Pennsylvania for the president today.
That's right. Much more of the same there from Donald Trump, telling his supporters what they want to hear rather than the facts. It's very hard for him to dispute the coronavirus figures that we're now seeing. A second resurgence, higher figures in recent days than we saw during the summer surge. Yet he continues to tell his rallies that we're rounding the curve, that a vaccine is imminent and that all people want to talk about, or all they want to talk about, referring to the Democrats, is COVID, COVID, COVID. And as the president in the grips of an election cycle, of course, as well, it seems irresponsible that there is no medical advice coming from the White House, just political argument. But that is what we are hearing from Donald Trump now, of course, with just the election 8 days away and coronavirus very much the issue that is of most concern to voters. And yes, in Pennsylvania, once again today, attending three rallies there, which, of course, we may not know whether they end up being super spreader events themselves until after people have voted. Of course, the election is so close now. This is the last full week of campaigning. And let's not forget that early voting is at a record high. 60 million people in the US have now voted early, around a third of ballots cast already. So this is a race against the clock for Donald Trump to try and make up ground against Joe Biden, who leads him in the polls. Joe Biden having a quiet day today. We won't see him back on the campaign trail until tomorrow in Atlanta and Georgia. And, of course, the president's vice president, Mike Pence, his own team now suffering contagion problems. Five of his staff members have tested positive in the last few days, yet he remains on the campaign trail himself in Minnesota today. So for Donald Trump to say that we're rounding the curve, the worst of the pandemic is behind us, it's very hard for him to argue when he's still dealing with contagion problems within his own White House. Now, Pennsylvania, of course, is a key battleground state. Pennsylvania itself has seen a resurgence in coronavirus record numbers in recent days, along with many other battleground states as well. To give you an idea, hospitalizations are up 40% in the last month when it comes to COVID-related cases. And cases in Pennsylvania alone are up 38% in the last 14 days. Now, Donald Trump has constantly campaigned against mail-in ballots, postal voting, as we call it in the UK. He sowed the seeds of distrust when it comes to voting by mail, knowing that Democrats are more likely to vote early and more likely to vote by postal ballots. He's been banking on a big turnout of Republican voters on election day. But now, with coronavirus resurging across the country and in many battleground states, it could be that he may not see that big turnout. Yet Democrats have banked millions of early votes already. Just to give you an idea, in Pennsylvania alone, which is seen as potentially the tipping point in this election, whoever wins Pennsylvania will likely take the White House. Well, 70% of early ballots cast there have been for the Democrats.
Sally, thank you.